This square root and minus sign are going to be key for you ninjas learning the conjugate method here in just a few minutes. Now, the reason why I'm using the conjugate method here is because if I plug in this value 0, you'll notice that you'll end up dividing by 0, which isn't allowed. So here's how you get the conjugate. What you do is you take the top, this square root expression, and the original constant 3, but whatever the operation in between was, whether it's a minus or a plus, take the opposite of that, and for that result, you multiply the top and the bottom by the conjugate. And the reason why we're doing this is because now if you look at the numerator, you've got the square root of x plus 9 minus 3 times the square root of x plus 9 plus 3. So that looks very similar to an expression a minus b times a plus b, right? Well, if you remember, those are the factors when you have something like a squared minus b squared. And so by inspection, it's very quick now to just rewrite the numerator as the first term squared minus the second term squared. So what's cool about this is, as you can see now, we are undoing the square root on the numerator. And so the top is going to simplify to x plus 9 minus 9. And that's really simple, right? That's just going to give you x. And check this out. We can actually cancel x from the top and the bottom. And it's safe because we don't have to worry about x being 0 on the denominator here because this is a limit. And so we're just approaching 0. And what this simplifies further to is now something where you can actually plug in 0 for x and not worry about dividing by 0, because this will just give you an answer of 1.